Hi, my name is Emily Rubino, and I'm Director of Policy and Outreach at Peace Action New York State, as well as an IPB Council member. I would like to voice my solidarity with the Nuclear Free Europe campaign. There are at least 5 countries in Europe holding U.S. nuclear weapons, adding up to roughly 150 weapons total. These countries are Germany, Belgium, the Netherlands, Italy, and Turkey. It is my hope that the citizens of these countries and of others in Europe under the U.S. nuclear umbrella will continue to think critically about the notion of common security and what truly makes us safe. The COVID-19 pandemic has shown us that the U.S. priorities, and that of many other countries, are clearly in the wrong place. Our massive military budget and nuclear arsenal and plans for modernization in the U.S. did not save us from the devastating death toll of this pandemic, nor its economic consequences. Hosting U.S. nuclear weapons did not help any part of Europe combat the pandemic or its economic downturn either. 75 years after the bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, I find it fascinating that Germany and Italy, who were at the time considered enemies of the United States, are now storing U.S. nuclear weapons. We bombed Japan and caused unimaginable suffering, but 75 years later, we're storing our weapons in Europe, mostly Western Europe, and continuing to threaten countries in Asia, the Pacific, and other parts of the globe. Nuclear weapons have always had a colonial and racist history. As we continue to reckon with our legacies of racism and all of the ways that it manifests, I hope that we can include nuclear weapons in this conversation and work to eliminate them from our respective countries. If the United States will not listen to the 122 nations that have ratified and 40 nations that have so far signed on to the Treaty of the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons, maybe they will listen to some of our allies in Europe. We must stop this us versus them mentality when it comes to nuclear weapons. There is no winnable nuclear war, and it is therefore all of our responsibilities to work for a nuclear-free future. This campaign is another step in that direction. Thank you.